Can I sue a school for not following an IEP? A school or school district can be sued for not following an IEP. Under the Individuals with Disabilities Education Act, all students have a right to a free and appropriate public education in the least restrictive environment. If your child has special needs or learning difficulties, they may need an IEP, Individualized Education Plan, or a 504 plan to make progress in school. In these circumstances, you may need to consult an education lawyer or special needs advocate to ensure that your child is getting the additional services they are entitled to. Here's a quick guide. What is IEP or an Individualized Education Program? An IEP or Individualized Education Plan is a written plan that lays out specific accommodations and measurable goals for students who have trouble learning in the context of a general public education curriculum. IEPs may be developed for a wide range of disabilities and impairments. That includes slight impairments or severe impairments. Plans are individually tailored to the student's needs. IEPs are created and reevaluated using a team approach, and they represent a collaborative effort between students, parents, special education professionals, and other school personnel familiar with a child's unique learning needs. Can I sue a school for not following an IEP? For obvious reasons, it is always ideal for parents to remain on friendly and cooperative terms with school administrators. But in some circumstances, a parent has tried everything, and they can't get their child the much-needed services and accommodations the child deserves. And the school district may be continually falling short. In these cases, you may want to speak with a special education advocate to explore your administrative and legal options. Public school districts. Federal and state laws require all public schools and certain private schools receiving government funding to provide IEPs or 504 plans to students with special needs. If a student is denied an IEP or 504 plan, an education attorney can take legal action in a number of ways. They can initiate mediation proceedings, file a formal complaint with the school, request an administrative or due process hearing, and file a lawsuit with the applicable court within 90 days after the adjudication of the hearing. Private or independent schools. Because they generally do not receive government funding, private and independent schools are generally not required to provide IEPs, 504 plans, or any other special needs services. However, if a private school advertises or states in their contract that they provide special education services, commonly called individual services plans or instructional services plans, and they fail to do so, you may then be able to take legal action against the school. Can I sue a school for an IEP payout? In limited circumstances, you may receive funds from the school district over an IEP dispute. For example, if you can prove that a private school tuition should have been paid by the public school district because it was unable to accommodate your child based on your child's disabilities, you may receive a payout. You may also receive compensation for additional tutoring or other services you paid for yourself in place of an IEP that should have been implemented or one that was inadequate or poorly administered. Though rare, in some cases, you may sue a school district for damages if you can prove that the school failed to provide legally required special needs services intentionally or with deliberate indifference. Can I sue school corporations or districts over an IEP denial? Yes, if it comes down to that. But before you actually bring a lawsuit against a public school, you must have gone through the school's own administrative process for appealing the decision. You should still retain the services of an education lawyer throughout this process. While public schools are required to administer their own special needs evaluations, some parents appealing an IEP denial pay to have an independent education evaluation, or IEE, done by an outside professional not affiliated with the school. If the IEE determines that your child has learning difficulties sufficient to require special needs services, the public school will often revise its decision and agree to provide the appropriate IEP. If your child is still denied an IEP after you appeal the school's decision, you may request an administrative or due process hearing, where an impartial hearing officer listens to both your arguments and the school's arguments before making a decision. You will want to consult a special needs advocate or education lawyer if you request a due process hearing. How much does it cost to sue a school? The cost of suing a school varies significantly based on the nature of the case, where you live, and the experience level of your counsel. Except in cases like class action lawsuits or suits involving high dollar amounts in damages, for the most part, education attorneys will charge an hourly fee upfront and throughout the duration of your case. Many education lawyers do offer a free initial consultation, however, and after learning the specific facts of your case, they will give you a more detailed estimate of their fees. If cost is a prohibitive factor, feel free to talk to your lawyer about strategies for keeping costs down. Can I bring an attorney to an IEP meeting? Yes, you technically have a right to bring an attorney to an IEP meeting. Keep in mind, however, that bringing a lawyer to your IEP meeting may create an adversarial atmosphere that can be counterproductive to cooperation between you and your child's school. And if you do bring an attorney to an IEP meeting, your school may reschedule the meeting until they can have their own counsel present. Your special education attorney will advise you on the wisest way to proceed when it comes to their attendance at an IEP meeting. When should I contact an education attorney? You should contact an education attorney if your child is being mistreated, neglected, harassed, bullied, wrongfully suspended or expelled, or discriminated against at school. Education attorneys deal with a wide variety of legal issues pertaining to students' rights. That includes special needs accommodations and Title IX issues. Though public schools and certain private schools receiving government funding enjoy immunity from many different types of lawsuits, that immunity is not absolute. Before you can sue a public school, however, you must go through the district's own internal process for filing a formal complaint. You should always contact an education attorney before you do so, because the content of your complaint with the school will control what legal arguments you can make later in court. There are fewer legal barriers to suing a private school, and the process can be much different. Do I need an education attorney near me? We recommend finding an education attorney familiar with the school districts in the county where the case is being tried. An education lawyer in the same county as the school district will generally be more familiar with the civil courts versus an out-of-state attorney. Have questions? We protect people like you every day. Email us at hello@educationattorney.com. Thanks for watching.